Hey everybody, it's Lynnea. Today I'm going to be making a card using a couple of new items from Whimsy Stamps. So I have the Slimline Hill House die and the Spooky Kitty stamp set. And I'm also going to be bringing in the newer Chills word dies as well towards the end of this card. So I'm going to start by die cutting the Slimline Hill House from some black cardstock. And you can see as I have it on top of this white card base that it is just a tiny bit smaller than a Slimline 3¼ by 8¼ card. Now I wanted to have some color behind that black house, and I thought about a couple different ways to do it. You could do some masking and inking or some coloring, but I found the quickest way to do this was to do some die cut paper piecing. So I have die cut that Slimline Hill House die again from some purple cardstock. I only needed the top of the die, and I'm going to just take those purple pieces and piece them together. I did the same thing with the gray for the driveway. For the lights, I didn't want to have to fuss with all those tiny little square pieces of cardstock. So what I'm going to do is just lay that on top of my card base, and I'm using a Y17 Copic marker, and I'm just going to add some quick color behind where those lights are going to be. I did that directly on the card base, and it does not matter at all that they are messy and that they are going to peek out from behind the house, because I'm going to be piecing the paper on top of that. I also didn't want to have to fuss around with those little tiny purple pieces in the fence, so I just took a scrap piece of purple cardstock and glued it behind there and trimmed away the excess. I added some liquid adhesive behind my Slimline Hill House die and put that onto my white card base. And here's where you can see the messiness of that yellow Copic coloring. It is definitely peeking out from behind the house, but I'm just going to piece these purple pieces back in with some liquid adhesive. And this frame, because it's kind of like a wavy frame, I didn't get it adhered down just perfect, but because I use liquid adhesive, I can pop in that large purple piece and kind of squish those wavy lines up against my purple die cut piece. I'm just using liquid adhesive and adding that into the negative pieces and then popping in those paper pieced portions. It's really easy to do, just like a puzzle, and there are very few tiny little pieces because I chose to actually Copic color behind the lights. Okay, so once I have that done, I'm going to start working on my background. I wanted to have some of those Chills word dies brought in. These are from a previous but recent release. So I cut out a bunch of them from white cardstock, and I'm again using little dots of liquid glue. I have some tweezers just to keep my fingers glue free. I also use a piece of scrap cardstock to press these word die cuts onto my card. That's another way to keep my fingers glue free. I try my best because I hate those sticky fingers, and I actually end up leaving fingerprints like I did right here in this corner. So I'm going to cover that up. This is the Spooky Kitty stamp set. I colored one of those little kitties, and I need to cover up that little kind of like a grease mark from the glue. I had a little bit on the tip of my finger, and I want to cover that up. So I'm going to take my embossing buddy and add powder all over my card, and then I'm going to stamp the boo from the Spooky Kitties, and I will heat emboss that with white powder. I didn't want to have just one boo down in the corner. I thought that that would be a little too blatantly obvious with just one. So I ended up stamping four and kind of staggering them back and forth across my card panel. I heated up my heat gun so it was really good and hot, and then I heat embossed those. Then I just take a dry cloth and wipe away the excess powder that's left from my embossing buddy. I'm going to use a clear shimmer pen and add some shimmer all over my little haunted house and the driveway as well. I'll add my Spooky Kitty onto the top of my Slimline Hill House scene. And that's it. This card is all done. I hope you love this fun, spooky Slimline card. Thanks you guys for watching. I'll see you soon. Bye. If you guys liked today's video, I encourage you to subscribe to my channel, and here are a few other videos I thought you might like.